Oi! This is for learning and fun, not mischief. Keep it legit. In less than 5 minutes, I'm going to show how the qFlipper Zero Momentum custom firmware can be easily flashed to a qFlipper Zero using one of three simple methods. First, open up a browser and navigate to this URL. Don't panic. The link is in the description. This URL will take you to the Momentum Firmware website. Now click GitHub in the menu bar. This will take you to NextFlip, who are the developers of Momentum. Click on Momentum Firmware Repository. Scroll down the page till you see this. Now click Install. Under Install, there is three easy methods of installation to choose from. Momentum recommends the web updater. I recommend the Q package, but who cares what I think? And just in case this isn't exciting enough already, there is also a zipped archive method. Now I'm going to show you how to use all three of these super simple methods, starting with the option I hate the least and finishing up with the option I hate the most. Option 1, least hated option, the qFlipper package. First of all, if you've been fapping about trying to flash this firmware to a qFlipper some other way, make sure you have the web updater and lab.qFlipper.net closed. Otherwise, you're going to run into more problems than you're probably already going to while doing this. Ominous, eh? Anyway, go ahead and click qFlipper package under download, and well, download. Once downloaded, open qFlipper and then connect the qFlipper Zero. Now you could go ahead and simply click install from file, or what I recommend before installing any custom firmware is to install the most recent version of the stock firmware first. This gives you the latest stock firmware to fall back to if you fuck something up. To do this, simply click install in qFlipper and install the latest version of the stock firmware. Once the qFlipper has updated to the latest stock firmware, it's ready to flash the Momentum custom firmware. So flash the stock firmware first, fight a kangaroo, I really don't care. Once you've done that or not, click install from file and select the file you downloaded earlier. Now the qFlipper Zero will do its thing. You can follow the progress on the qFlipper because it's uber exciting. Once it's done, it's done. Momentum firmware installed. Yay. Right, option 2, the zipped archive. Open up a browser again and navigate to Momentum's website again. Click the GitHub button that leads to their GitHub page and choose the Momentum firmware repository. Now this time, instead of choosing the qFlipper package, choose the zipped archive and download it. Once downloaded, open the folder you downloaded it into, right-click it, and select Extract to extract it to whichever folder you want. Now open qFlipper and click on the File Manager, then double-click SD card, then double-click Update. Now open the folder where you extracted that zipped archive to in a separate window and drag it into the Update folder of the qFlipper Zero's SD card. Now on the qFlipper, press the arrow down button once and then press the arrow right button 3 times or until you see the Update folder. Press the middle button to open the Update folder, then select the firmware file inside that you just uploaded and press the middle button. Now press the down arrow to get to Update and press the middle button. Press the middle button again to choose Run in App. Finally, press the right arrow button to install. Frick, that was a mouthful. Anyways, neck minute or tree, Momentum firmware installed. Yep. Finally, option 3, the web updater. Open up your favorite vomit flavored Chromium based spyware browser. I personally chose Chromium for this dirty little experiment. Once you have your filthy Chromium based browser open, navigate to Momentum's official website again. Link in the description. Up to you if you want to flash the latest stock firmware before flashing custom firmware. Just make sure you have qFlipper closed before trying this method or it will not work. Now click on the install button on Momentum's website, which will open the web updater. Then click connect on the web updater and connect the qFlipper to the computer. Choose the qFlipper Zero, click connect again, and voila. Simply select flash, and the dolphin will immediately pull its pants up and gets to work flashing the firmware for you. Want to know what you're actually going to get with Momentum before you start playing with your dolphin's fiddly bits? Check out this video. Else why you're still here? Don't you got some custom firmware to install? I ain't judging. I've got a bunch of more ball hit videos you can watch if you want. Have a look.